Excuse me. Someone.
I don't know.
I don't know if this is gonna go on YouTube or not. I just want to record something. I don't know if I actually want to upload or something, but I can at least try to record an episode and see how things go. To test if I want to do that or not. So yeah, I'm studying new save on classic. Now, I'm pretty good at this game. I have all the achievements. So yeah. In worlds beyond, they speak your name with regrets and regret. For none could tame our savage souls yet. To you, the challenge met. Under palest watch, you taught. We changed face instinct. We redeemed a world you gave to bug and beast as they had never dreamed. Yeah, by Monomon. As you can see, I have a 112% save, so I don't really, I of course know what this is, so yeah, there's me. Oh yeah, and if you haven't actually played Hollow Knight before, do it before you watch this video, because I'm gonna be progressing really far since I know how to play the game. So yeah, go play it before you watch this series or something if it goes on YouTube. I'm actually gonna go inside here because I want money. Getting some early cash is useful because then you can buy some tools fast. You'll progress faster. Haha, idiot. If you go to the left there, you can get 50 more Giro here. Oh, one. There. Now, a cool little trick. You might think, because this is a Metroidvania, that you need some specials to get over here, and you can use that. However, you can just pogo. It's very simple. And then you get your first charm, just like that. And that's the reason I didn't go and collect this rock before, because I was going to end up right with it anyways. Now I cannot perform the cool King's Pass skip anymore, because I already did it. Oops. What? How do you do that? I don't know how you do that. wait, no, menu dropping was... that was the menu, yeah, so you need to... walk, that's the reason you need dash to do it. In this version you can also menu drop, but it's harder. Hello, elder bug. If you go past here, always talk to this guy. Oh there, traveler. I'm afraid there's only me to left to offer welcome. Our town has fallen quiet, you see. The other residents, they've all disappeared. Head down that well, one by one, into the caverns below. Used to be there was a great kingdom beneath our town. It's long felt a ruin, yet it still draws folks into its depth. Wealth, glory, enlightenment, dark darkness seems to promise all the things. I'm sure you too seek your dreams down there. Well, watch out. It's a sickly air that fills the place. Creatures turn mad and travelers are robbed from their memories. Perhaps dreams aren't such great things after all. Many used to come, hoping the kingdom will fulfill their desires. Hellenest, it was once called. Supposedly the greatest kingdom there ever was, full of treasures and secrets. Now it's nothing more than a poisonous tomb full of monsters and madness. Everything fades, eventually, I suppose. Feeling tired? That bench may be iron, but I assure you it's quite comfortable. There's no better place to collect your thoughts before heading below. Plus, I enjoy the company. Not that you seem the talkative sort. Yeah. So I actually, I can't talk. This shop opens once you meet Cornifer for the first time. I know you usually go to the left first, but I'm just going to ride to the right to meet Quirrell. Hello there, how delightful to meet another traveller on these forgotten roads. You're a short one, but you look... I'm not short! What do you mean? What do you mean I'm short? I'm not short. Well, in game I am, but... I'm Quirrell. I have something of an obsession with uncharted places. This ancient kingdom holds many fascinating mysteries, and one of the most intriguing of them is this standing right before us. A great stone egg lying in the corpse of an ancient kingdom. And this egg, is it warm? It certainly gives off a unique air. Can it be opened? There are strange marks all over it. I do so love a mystery. And who knows what other marvels lie even deeper below us. Yeah, this egg is very easily opened by defeating, by dreamlanding all three dreamers in the game. So yeah. Was there ever anything up here? No, there wasn't. In here, there's a little guy that needs saving. Ow. There you go. Easy battle. So yeah, that's called the grub, and they're cute, and you get money for saving them, so... Well, not only money, you actually get, like, health and charms and lots of cool things. In here is Myla, yes. Wait, hold up. Oh, bury the knight with a broken nail. Bury the priest. Something about the crown. I can't remember the rest of that one. Maybe I'll just hum it. Yeah. Then in here you need special things. Again, I'm not gonna spoil it, this is just gonna be a first episode. I'm not gonna say that much, even though I mentioned the Dreamers. They're important later. It's that big of a deal. It's a little bit annoying that I can't dash yet, because dash is like one of the is your most important maneuverability. Actually, that's claw, but dash makes you move faster, so. What? Hello? Come here. Watch this. Just like that. Normally you need dash for that, but pogoing is a thing, so it's not a big deal. So yeah, that was what I wanted to do over there. Now, is there anything in this room? There is some money here. Oops. There isn't anything more in this room, but however, if I go over here, there's a georock or something. Yeah, this one. I'm just taking the long way, just because I want to explore everything first. Maybe I should try menu dropping. Okay. No, menu dropping is really hard in this version. In the 1.2.1 patch, you can just drop whenever you want, but in this patch is really hard. Anyways, hello there, come down to explore these beautiful old ruins. Don't mind me, I have a fond death for exploring myself. Getting lost and finding your way again is a pleasure like no other. We're exquisitely lucky, you and I. I'm a cartographer by trade, and I'm working on mapping this area right now. Would you like to buy a copy of my work so far? Yes, please. Acquired a map. A map can be a useful thing, but it alone won't show you where you are. If you're not the head for directions, I suggest purchasing a compass from my wife, Isella. She's just now opening a new map shop in Dirtmouth, selling all sorts of useful things to wanderers like you. Like yourself. She'll even sell some of my old maps from time to time. I pop back to see her whenever I finish mapping an area. She's always so excited to see me. Mm-hmm. Oh, by the way, I haven't introduced myself, have I? Yes, I should apologize for that. when you spend a lot of time by yourself, with just your own thoughts, you forget the niceness of a conversation. My name is Confer, and I've always loved exploring the world. Why? When I was first hatched, I wandered off immediately, leaving my brothers and sisters and poor mother behind. That's why, as soon as I could, I moved to Deathmouth with my wife, a huge, unending kingdom to explore right on our doorstep. Who could resist? Anyway, I'll let you return to your travels. With a little luck, we'll meet again. Be safe and farewell. Yeah, continue working on your map. Here's another thing you can go over here and save another little grubby. You can actually perform an acid skip. Yeah, well. It's pretty hard, and I do not have the right tools for it at all. So yeah. Now I'm just going. As I said, I know what I'm doing. So the game's gonna look really smooth for me. And I can pretty much guarantee you that it will not be as smooth for you. Because, yeah. Things are always easier when you know what you're doing. I don't know how to... I'm not a speedrunner. I've never actually... I think I've hit one of them before. Oh wow, you little shit. You little shit. And that's the place of the fungal wastes. And I can't go there yet because... I don't have the stuff. Anyways, there's a bench now. I'm not gonna sit on it because why would I? Why would I sit on it? Now, I'm gonna try a pretty hard skip to get that mask shard up there because, well, it's a mask shard. It's nice to have. Get the attention of you. I need to keep you up. I need to pogo on you. Yeah, I did it. That's a pretty hard skip. Well, actually, it isn't that hard, but before I was kind of bad at this game, so I thought it was hard. People actually say that skip is hard and they think it's really annoying. But it is pretty easy, you just have to pogo in the gomes. Anyways, free mask shard. Let's go. And no, do not try that at the beginning of your journey. You're just gonna end up getting annoyed. I can guarantee you that much. Yeah, I do recommend looking for these signs and following them. These right here. Or a sign with a bench, because bench are basically checkpoints. Now, I didn't take the bench because I can bench warp. So this is a bench that I will take because it's at a stag. Then I can go straight up to Dreadnought again. Greetings, little one. It's been an age since I last heard the ringing of a station bell. It echoed down the stagways and called me to you. I've grown stiff and tired over these many years, and I've forgotten much, but the sound of the bell will always call me back. These stagways stretch the depths of Hallownest. If you want to travel them, hail me from the platform. It will take you where you need to go. Now I can go to Dirtmouth. Open this up. I can go and buy mapping things.
Bapanada.
Bapanada. I'm probably just gonna buy the stag and bench pin. Yes. Now I can look on the map wherever there are stags and benches. Yeah, and I need to go to False Knight, yes, that's what you called. So yeah, then it's just that ways to Chris Mother. I'm probably just gonna do the False Knight first. Yeah. Oops. I was actually supposed to go in here, but I didn't intend on that, so it's oops. Yes, I'm in Dirtmouth and I want to go to Dirtmouth. The stag was just like standing there like dude, do you have Alzheimer's or something? Is a grub behind this wall, although there are two aspids here, so you have to be careful. There you go. I got that. The reason I didn't come here earlier was because I would have been blocked off by this, but now I can go through there. There is a way up here, and I can't spike her yet. But once I get claw and dash, I can spike and tunnel through here. The reason you need claw is because there's a wall at the end that you can't pass through unless you have wall climb. So yeah. Nothing more advanced than that. Now it's time to spice things up a little bit. I want to get Vengeful Spirit because that's one of the most useful things in early game. There's a surprising amount of people that don't use this. I mean, don't use it, but they use it way less than they could.